The Flagstaff County Skills Day starts here in a town with medieval names. Not far from the corner of Galahad and Guinevere is Sir Galahad himself, nobly standing guard over rail lines and graineries. But why is he locked up behind a wire mesh fence?
The rumours are that one of the graduating classes back in kind of the mid-90s tried to decapitate Sir Galahad.
Katrina Smith manages the Galahad Health Centre. There are 20 long-term care beds here, and today she is touring 55 post-secondary healthcare students from Calgary.
Work-life balance is phenomenal.
Katrina worked in Calgary for 10 years as an RN, but left to practice and start a family in rural Alberta.
Best decision I ever made. Coming out here from a work perspective, it gives me the opportunity to expand my scope as a nurse.
Next, paramedics simulate the rescue of a stroke patient, in this case, played by a healthy student.
Just give yourself a little hug if you can. And it's gonna feel weird, but we've got you, okay?
We used to have to operate a stretcher with two people. We now operate a stretcher with just one person.
Advanced care paramedic Gordon Stevenson, based in nearby Forestburg, loves the challenges of working rurally.
It's incredible. It's a long transport time, so you get more interaction with your patients. You really get to utilize all your skill sets and make a difference.
Back on the bus and northbound to Killam, a community of roughly 1,000 people that serves a large farming community. The rest of this skills day will be held here at the Killam Healthcare Center.
Have you seen my wife?
Can't say I have.
What did you say?
Nope.
What did you say?
No.
Unique to this event is a dementia simulation.
I have to go to the bathroom.
You just went.
Half the students play the role of a dementia patient while the others observe. Then they switch. The goal?
Teach students what it's like to have this disease and be able to empathize with them and not treat them like a child, rather treat them as a human being that has a disease.
Jerry Clark, site administrator at the Killam Health Center, played a large part in organizing the day. She's hopeful that some of the students will return here someday.
Down the road, maybe they'll have something in their back of their mind that one day it might be nice to come to rural Alberta.
I've always pictured myself, I think, raising my kids in a small place where everyone knows everyone.
Every day is a little bit of a change. You get to have a closer relationship with the people around you, I think is fantastic. So yeah, it's all very attractive to me.
And I'm just gonna go to the left a little bit.
Dr. Sam Obidi led the ultrasound station. He later spoke to the students at the dinner.
Working as a physician in a rural area is the best kept secret as a medical professional. You get way more job satisfaction working in the rural area.
They also heard from a physiotherapist who didn't know anyone when she first came here from Toronto.
But it was an amazing experience. Everyone was so welcoming. I got more hugs here than I ever did in Toronto, I think.
The students toured a couple of the bigger employers in the area. Battle River Implements has a farm equipment inventory of over $40 million.
We have one gentleman south of town, seeds 45,000 acres.
On the way back to Calgary, a stop at ATCO's Battle River Generating Station. About 100 people work here and supply power to 300,000 homes. Then it's homeward bound with a better idea of what rural practice and lifestyle are like in Flagstaff County.